business, they're moving on. Yeah, they're giving up now. Don't lose your nerves. You're videoing, sure.
Everybody
yeah.
Survived.
Yeah, that's the old bloody not believe it.
Look at this one. Can you believe that this one can actually stand on a face like this? Because most of the dogs have lost interest here. The wild dog.
Yeah,
the same thing. But then we saw them looking in the side of the way. The baby is probably in the best position because the wild dogs can't actually leverage themselves on anything to get that low. But it's just a shear. This male, that the wild dogs are pretty close to him. If he had kind of flint, he might have put himself in a more precarious position. Unfortunately, they're just outnumbered here, so if you watch them, you have nice perspective because they're that side of an area where that young sort of bouncing around the rock. So you see that they're very agile on them, but I don't think their agility will be a match for a pack of wild dogs this big should they choose to feed.
Right. And we don't have enough rocks today.
Yeah, I mean, with those trees here, I don't know what it looks like behind them, but I know that there are a number of wild dogs that are. There were some that went up in that direction.
They split like that.
Yeah. Yeah, they would. And then they do like a long to try and contact call to one another. So everyone in the pack will do that in different areas, and that's how they locate one another.
You can cover it like that. You spot the land.
Yeah.
And find two different kills and then go back to them.
Yeah.
So
it was nice to be able to watch from the band and reflect a little bit because of the